In this demo, what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to set up Coder from scratch. Don't worry, that only takes a couple of seconds. And then we're going to build a template without using any modules from the registry. And then we're going to add in some modules. So let's get started. We're on Coder server. And then, oops. We'll just create our first user. Oops. And we will not start a trial today. And then what we'll do is we'll go back and we'll create a template. So first we'll log in real quick. Oops. And we'll paste that. Oops. There we go. Okay. Now the Coder templates create. Okay. And we'll just walk through this template real quick just to show you what it's doing. It's a really basic Docker template that actually uses Env Builder. And so what it's doing is it's actually cloning the static get URL right now. So this is the repo we're starting from. It is really basic. It's really just a starter container. So let's create a workspace from this. I'll just call it a demo. Now, if I take a look, I do Docker PS, we can see that that container is alive outside of my machine. And what it actually did is, we can see the logs here, is it ran Env Builder, and it cloned down the repo, and then it really just built the container. I'll make this a little bigger so you can see. And now as an admin, what I might want to do, or like as a DevOps person, what I might want to do is I might want to add some extensions to my environment. And so what I can do is I can go to the registry and I can start browsing. And so some of my devs maybe complained and they're like, oh, I want to add some customizations. Like I want to use my own shell or I want to add some .dot files. And so I could add personalization. Or maybe I want to add code server so that people can have VS Code in the browser, since it's not there right now. And we have a bunch of samples. You can actually see we have kind of what Amar talked about with our integration with JFrog, along with a bunch of just like really nice to haves, like GCP region, so that you don't actually have to do this yourself a million and one times. We also render all like the parameters and variables and even just the source if you really want to take a look at it. So it's really easy to introspect these things. So we'll actually add two of them in here. We'll add the personalize in, which I'm just going to uncomment here. And then we'll add code server in. And with code server, let's actually do some customization with it. We'll scroll down and check out the examples. And we'll actually pre-install some extensions as well. And we'll actually make sure that that theme that we just installed as an extension is also set by default inside of the workspace. One of the questions we get asked a ton is how people do stuff like this, which is like, how do I pre-configure the extensions inside with code server, or how do I do the settings? And so our answer to that is really now, like we want to create these nice little isolated modules that people can use so that just if you want to, you can get this really simple setup out of the box. So now we'll push this template. We'll update it. And now you can see it downloaded the modules. And now what you can actually see, which is cool, is it ran the personalized script. And you can see that, that's the personalize. And right now it's actually installing code server as well. You can see we still have all the Env Builder logs, which is nice. And soon in a second, we will have code server. And as you can see in the logs there, it also installed the extension and it also created the settings file. So now if I open this up, what we'll see is it actually has everything pre-configured, which is nice. So if I go to extensions, it has the Dracula extension, and it's also entirely configured. And the cool thing about that is like before, that was a much more complex operation to have happen. I can actually show you the source of this file real quick, or of this module. Let's see what I'm gonna. It's pretty basic. It really just runs this script. But even this boilerplate for you to have to make and maintain kind of sucks. And something that's cool is we have tests for each one of these modules as well. And so you can see, you know, if you want to like get clone a repo, that's obviously really easy, but to make it nice so that nice errors appear and nice messages appear for your users so they can actually take some action, there's some complexity. And so it's cool because each of these are tested as well. And you can see that on the registry. And then one other thing I'll show you, which is something that will be released soon, is the ability to actually rebuild the environment essentially with a dev container entirely from VS Code and kind of do the like fast rebuild like I talked about. And so let's say inside of this environment right now, which is the one I just built, I want to add HTOP. So I will add HTOP to my Docker file inside of my dev container. And then what I can actually do is just call rebuild workspace. And if we actually take a look at the dashboard, you'll see it actually entirely kind of did just like a reset on the workspace. And so all these operations are running again and we're reconnecting, which is cool. And so very similar to, you know, if you use like the dev containers extension from VS Code before, you'll have an extremely similar workflow, but now inside of a Coder workspace, now I have HTOP. And, you know, you can obviously get this on any infra too. So I'm using a Docker container right now, but this obviously works on like, you know, Kubernetes or OpenShift or inside of a VM if you want it. That's more or less it. All the modules are live and you can create your own and contribute them and add in a pull request along with tests. You can actually set yourself too as a maintainer. Right now, all the modules are obviously maintained by us because we just launched it, but, and you can kind of like independently maintain your own module that'll show up on the registry.